everyone, especially to my viewers and to you, Sir Sarno. For today's video, I will discuss the common issues in our community. But before I discuss, I will introduce myself first. My name is Daisy C. Vergara, BS Criminology 1, Section Bravo. Okay, let's proceed to our discussion. So for today's discussion, I will discuss my common issues which entitled Campaign Against Illegal Drugs. So there are four objectives. So first, in context, the Philippine Campaign Against Illegal Drugs as a part of President Rodrigo Duterte's approach to human development and governance, and as a response to the pandemic nature of drugs problem and its correlations with criminality. Second, underscored that the campaign against illegal drugs is not discriminatory. Emphasized that on the issue of killings, the government does not sanction killings committed outside legitimate operation, and this together with killings perpetrated by drug syndicates are being investigated and prosecuted. Fourth, called on all states and international organization and agency to support the Philippine campaign against illegal drugs. So okay guys, let's proceed to the anti-illegal drug campaign. So the anti-illegal drug or AID campaign is being carried out under the national agenda to uplift the dignity and human rights of the Filipinos through inclusive development. So when Duterte said, human right must work to uplift human dignity. So the Philippines is facing a grave social ill that has been existing for many years. The massive proliferation of illegal drugs, the drug menace is compounded by other social ills such as rampant criminality, lingering poverty, and corruption in the bureaucracy. So in its exercise of sovereignty and self-determination, the Philippines is resolute in the saving its people from the scourge of illicit drugs. The Filipino people support the President's platform on peace and order based on his consistent high approval and trust rating. So I will choose the campaign illegal drugs because based on my barangay, there are many using drugs. In my barangay, last July 2021, the PDEA was come in our barangay to talk the person who in use illegal drugs. Some of the person are arrested and some is not because they ran away. But now, last month, all persons using drugs are all arrested. So now, let's talk about the executive orders. First, the right to life of every Filipino and their right to a society conducive for development have been eroded by widespread drug abuse. The right to life of every Filipino, including their right to live in a society that allows for a development of their full human potential, has been eroded by the sad state of peace and order in many communities brought about the drugs problem, the magnitude of which has only been realized in the current administration. Statistics shows that Philippine drug problem has been growing in the recent years between 2021 and 2015. The number of confirmed positives in voluntary drug test result has risen from 1,383 to 16,838. Admissions in rehabilitation centers have risen from 2,744 to 5,402, of which new admission numbered 4,392, the highest in 10 years. The number of persons arrested in cases filed by the Philippine Drug Enforcement Authority or PDEA has risen from 10,159 to 19,432. Anti-illegal drugs operation conducted have risen from 15,613 to 25,000 41. So the drug problem has been strongly correlated to criminality in the country. Serious crime that include rape with homicide, murder, kidnapping, armed assault, robbery, and so on have been posed serious threats to community across to the Philippines. Second, the state affirms its sole obligation to protect its people by addressing the drug problem through a holistic institutional approach. Even prior to 2016, the following five pillars of action supported the Philippines government's strategies to address the drug problem. Drug supply reduction covers law enforcement, regulatory compliance, judicial and legislative measure, and sectoral capacity building programs. Drug demand reduction covers policy formulation, preventive education programs, treatment and rehabilitation, and research. Alternative development seek the reduction of production of marijuana and eliminates its cultivation through sustainable rural developments and alternative livelihood. Civic awareness and response. Conventional and social media and social civic partnership are mobilized in the campaign against illegal drugs. 3. The state recognizes the drug problem as a health issue and promotes and protects the drug user's right to health. To address the number of drugs users and pushers seeking drug treatment, that rehabilitation. The president ordered the establishment and support of drug abuse treatment and rehabilitation center under executive number 4. Let's talk about the Republic Act. Congress of Philippine 12th Congress first regular session, Republic Act number 1965, June 7, 2002. An act instituting the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002. Repealing Republic Act No. 6425, otherwise known as the Dangerous Drugs Act of 1972, as amended, providing funds therefore and for other purposes. Section 1, short title, this act shall be known and cited as the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002. Section 2. Declaration of policy. It is the policy of the state to safeguard the integrity of its territory and the well-being of its citizenry, particularly the youth, from the harmful effects of dangerous drugs on their physical and mental well-being, and to define the same against act or omission detrimental to their development and preservation. In this topic, the criminological theory is neutralization theory. So, neutralization theory was developed as means for explaining how criminal offender engage in rule-breaking activity while negativing the culpability or blame. This contrasts other theories regarding criminal behavior. So, okay, my suggestion to address these issues or problems are avoiding places where you know drugs and alcohol will be available. Second, surrounding yourself with friends who don't use drugs. Third, knowing to the resist temptation. Fourth, learning how to cope with stress and relax without drugs. Fifth, distracting yourself with activities like exercise or listening to music. That would be all. Thank you for listening and watching. God bless you. Once again, good day, everyone.